Hello, welcome or welcome back to kfarian.com, whether you have found me on my YouTube channel or my blog. Today is day 25 in the 30-day minimalist challenge, and today is actually the day that I'm going to make a run for the finish line. So I've got counting today, I have 6 days left, and I'm highly motivated to get the last of this stuff out of my house and out of my office, which is a little bit overwhelming at the moment with stuff. I'm gonna make a mad dash run for the end. We'll see if I can get through it all today or over the next couple of days. We'll see what I can do. So day 25 of the 30-day minimalist challenge. So I'm getting to the point where there's really too many items for me to display on my video. So I'm going to just kind of go through the list really quickly of everything that I'm getting rid of today for day 25. So I've got two pillows, one large frame, one of those little hand fan doobop things that you kind of hold in your hand and fan yourself, battery operated. A Dracula Pez dispenser, an old watch, 5 pieces of makeup, 1 deck of cards, 1 candle that I somehow missed in my earlier candle purges, so I tossed that one in there, a set of earbuds that I don't really like. They don't really fit me very well, so I'm getting rid of those, a Cat5 cable, 2 old wireless routers. So on a top shelf in a closet in one of our spare bedrooms, I found a couple routers that we've been hanging onto for who knows how long. So those went into the donate pile. 7 balloons. So for some reason that I can't even possibly imagine, I had 7, you know, soft, ready to be blown up balloons. I'm getting rid of those. 3 sticky pads. So those are the like little notepads that I had overlooked in my earlier purge of notepads. A box of price stickers. So I'm an author and I go to signing events pretty regularly, and I sell physical books, or I have been selling physical books. So I've made the decision that I'm not going to do physical books anymore. I still have a number of them from the last round that I bought, so I will continue to do some events until I run out of books, and then I'm not doing physical books anymore. So if I'm not doing the physical books, I don't need the little price tag things that I can put on the book for the sale price for the actual signing event that I'm at. So I got rid of all of those price stickers. I got rid of 19 pens and markers. So like probably most people, I had an overwhelming supply of pens and markers. And frankly, I still have, you look behind me in that mug and in that jar there, I still have plenty of pens to go. I will probably be getting rid of more, but I got rid of 19 this round. And I had 3 bracelets that I bought while I was in Cambodia from some women who were a little bit annoying on the beach, but it's hard to be really annoyed when you're in Cambodia and you see the level of poverty that exists there. So we bought 3 beautifully braided bracelets, actually, but they're not anything that I want, so I'm going to go ahead and donate. And that comes out to, hopefully, if I did my math right, that adds up to 25. And then on top of that, I wanted to talk a little bit today about this idea of extreme minimalism. So far, I'm pretty much at the beginning of my minimalist journey. The 2 questions, though, that I am asking myself as I go through this 30-day challenge is, if you were to downsize to a house half the size that you're in now, what would you keep and what would you get rid of? And the second question I'm asking is, if I were to take off and travel for 2 years or 3 years and I had to pay to store everything that I decided to keep, what would I keep and what would I get rid of? And that's kind of been my guiding, my North Star goal, I guess, as I've been going through this minimalist challenge. But there are some folks who really take that to a degree that I hadn't really ever imagined it for a long term. I mean, when I sort of think about my journey, I think that I'll get rid of a good chunk of stuff, but I've never really thought too much about getting my things down to like 100 things or 50 things. And there are people who have done that. So there was, I'll post links to all of these in the notes below, but there was this video that I saw about this gentleman by the name of Mike, who was living the big life. He owned multiple multiple homes. He had his own online business that he felt uncomfortable with, but they were raking in money. He had a family of four. They, as I said, owned numerous houses. They, you know, they were well set financially. And he just realized one day that the business he was in was something that he really wasn't comfortable with. And I mean, just like that, like, bam, he just said, okay, I'm done. And he walked away from the business and he got rid of, he sold off the houses. He got rid of all of his stuff. And he's at the point now where he owns 50 things. Now he does live in a home with two of his children. I think they both still live with him. So they may have a few more things, but as they walked through the house and kind of pointed out what he owns, that total came out to actually less than 50 things. Which when I think to myself, you know, if I got everything in the world that I own down to 50 things, what would those 50 things be? And I don't know, that's a pretty small number to think about. Another video that I stumbled across that I thought was interesting was this guy who is something of a world traveler. I'm not super familiar with him at this point, but I'm going to dig a little bit more and see what I can find out. But he likes to travel, and he travels with no bags. Like, he travels with nothing. So he's got basically the clothes that he has on. He has a scarf, essentially, that he uses to either as a scarf, or he'll use it to like wrap, if he's got a book, he'll wrap his book in it and sling it across his shoulder, you know, and across his chest, like a bag. He carries everything else he needs in his pockets. So he's got the very, very basics of, you know, toothbrush and, you know, clothes and stuff like that. And that's it. That is what he travels with. And I thought that was quite interesting. I am a very light traveler. I've done long-term travel before. I definitely fit everything I need, even for a multi-month long trip, in a single backpack. So I don't have, you know, I get that, but I can't really imagine not carrying a backpack at all, and not having anything. So I thought that was really interesting. And then I stumbled on this gentleman too, by the name of Andrew Hyde. And I guess it sounds like he's maybe a big name in the minimalist, family. He's not somebody that I have come across before, but he is also a big time traveler, and he travels a lot, or at least he did travel a lot for business. I'm not sure if he's still in that same situation. And he basically had almost nothing as well. I mean, he has like a few, you know, a handful of clothes, one or two pairs of shoes, and that's about it. He doesn't own a home because he travels so much for business. So he owns no, you know, kitchen stuff, no furniture, no home, no car, all of those things. He owns none because he's on the road all of the time. And I thought that was interesting too, thinking about the kitchen stuff and all the gadgets that we tend to collect. And it's interesting to think, I mean, it's obviously a lot less expensive to eat in and to prepare your own food, and it's probably much healthier as well. But I really started to wonder, if you factor in the cost of everything else that goes along with having a sort of an American style kitchen, I wonder if it really still would come out ahead to prepare your own food rather than going out all of the time. Obviously, how you eat and the places that you choose would really play into that. And I'm not really sure what the waste situation would be like in there, but it prompted an interesting sort of thought exercise for me. Like, I'm wondering if that would really, from a cost perspective, clearly from a health perspective, I don't think you can get any better than prepping your own food, but from a cost perspective, really, whether it would really be that much more expensive to just eat out all the time if you didn't have to support a house and all of the things that go along with a kitchen. So anyway, those are some of my musings on extreme minimalism. One thing that was really interesting is I could not find examples of women who were really into this extreme minimalism thing. Now, I did find several women who were selling off most or the vast majority of their things because they were going to travel or move overseas, but they weren't necessarily living their life, you know, in this extreme minimal state. So I thought that was really interesting as well, and I'm not really sure what that's all about. So that's something that I think I'm going to have to dig into a little bit further as I go down this journey. But anyway, that is day 25 of the Minimalist Challenge. 5 days left, counting today, four going forward. And yeah, I'll see you tomorrow in the next video. Take care, everybody.